Angular 19 introduces a new experimental resource API for managed asynchronous operations. The primary use is fetching data from a remote server to update your component automatically. To create a resource, we use the resource function. This function takes an array of options. The loader option is the only required option. This option must contain a function to load the resource value. Inside, we use the fetch function to load this value. Next, parse the JSON response into a JavaScript object. This function is a loader function and must return a promise with the resource value. In this example, this is exactly what the fetch function does. Finally, the received value is stored in this resource. We can get this resource value using the value property. Since this property is a signal, we must add parentheses after its name. New to signals in Angular, check out my 20-minute tutorial. Look at the structure of this call. Let's display this resource value in the browser using interpolation. The first time this template displays, the request hasn't completed yet. As a result, the resource value is undefined. Adding optional chaining avoids errors. When the request completes, Angular updates this view automatically. Angular doesn't track changes on the remote server. Call reload to check for updates from the server. This method executes the loader function again. If received value differs from current one, Angular automatically updates the view. While the first request is in progress, additional reload calls are ignored. Reload returned true if the request was initialized, false if it wasn't. The value property is a signal, so we can update the resource value using update. This function must return the new resource value. Update allows us to create a new value based on the current value. This value is updated locally only. The remote server doesn't automatically receive the new resource value. We can also simply set a new value using set. No current value, no need function, only new value. This also only updates locally. Let's see how the resource API works with signals. To keep this example simple, the request doesn't include any parameters. Now, let's add a login parameter. This login property is a signal. Now, this resource gets the user by the login. What happens if the login changes? Angular doesn't send the new request automatically. Even if the signal changes, this loader function doesn't execute again. This happens because the loader is untracked for signals. It doesn't react to signal changes inside itself. We must use the request option. The loader executes every time the login property changes. Wrap multiple signals inside a function. The value property of the resource is a signal. We can use this value in computed signals and effects. When the resource value changes, computed signals recalculate and effects re-execute.